That's like, y'all know I don't do no poetry, right? I crack a few jokes. So somebody asked, we was talking to some of the other couples. So they was asking about marriage and our relationship and certain things. I was like, Ice, can you cook? This fool's talking about something. I cook hot dogs real good. I'm cold on the hot dog. So I got the on and off. That wasn't funny to y'all. That was funny to me. I didn't give y'all that part of the rules. Y'all have to laugh at all my jokes. My baby said he got hot dogs on lock. So we have a special performance. This brother, you just got that, cousin. This young man is coming from the East Coast, right, Ice? This young man is coming up there?
DMV.
That's right, that's right. Put y'all hands together. He has probably, this is probably his third time being here this year. It is always a pleasure. Put your hands together, clap your hands, stomp your feet. Brother Rob!
Ghetto tour guy.
Let's go, bro.
Yeah.
The projects is what we call the hood. Not that manufactured bullshit you see on the TV and the movie screens, whether be like the movement or what to be depicted, but the real hood with nothing is scripted. Specific in my invitation. I'm talking to all the pacifiers and liars, the ones that think they don't see color, all men are brothers. Yet you see black folk being killed daily by cops and each other. You don't speak out on it, you just whisper amongst each other. Yeah, I'm talking to y'all motherfuckers. So you can look at the movies and the videos and not be scared because your punk ass is up there. Now come to the truth in the city. But there's always somebody named Tawana, Tamika, Lakeisha, Tyrone, Don Ellis, possibly a nigga named Shitty. Not that they all look the same, but somewhere along the way, you might hear somebody yell out one of these names. And now, dear friends, our tour begins. Very seriously, I say watch your steps, because you never know what you're going to step on or in. Welcome to the ghetto, dear tourists and all that you need to list. We won't be going through any alleys today. We know that not everyone can stand the strong smell of urine or piss. You may notice no playgrounds, no swing sets, no basketball courts in this ghetto. This is why you see so many kids on the block, because they ain't got no place to go. See, they got back all the summer jobs and youth programs, just like the IRS. They take as much as they can from the poor, man. But the poor always knew how to make do when we didn't have enough. So we play street games. You know, hopscotch, freeze tag, red light, green light, hide and come get, double dutch. Some of the buildings still have security doors, but the phone pad, the call upstairs don't work no more. When you can't get a host center out front or on the ground floor. So you gotta go back to the old school way of doing things, I figure. You wanna hear somebody say, yo, Tyrone, come open up the door, fool. Well, my goodness. As you can see, it's overpopulation, very crowded, not much to do. So folks sit around on the balconies or hang around the front stoop. And you look off to your left, you see the first shallow dude, no water back in church, go back up at my man friend. And black folks, we got nothing, we got God and hope. And oh, by the way, that is pastor, two class Mercedes Benz. Next to the church, you'll see the dry cleaners, ran by Mr. Horton. Next to that, you see the convenience store, ran by Sheik Alouie. Next to that, you see the Japanese trade, ran by Mr. and Mrs. Fuji. These businesses have been around here for years. Funny how they don't ever have a decent sale or no special deals going on. Maybe because we black, I don't know what it is. And if you come up one big dime short of your purchase, trust me, they ain't telling you shit. Back to the old crowd issue, oh, it can't get hectic. Every once in a while, somebody pops and run on the front stoop for a ghetto picnic. This is when folks who think they choose to speak want to come outside and act like everything's cool. And here you come, just getting off work, tired of shit almost, excuse me, God damn, can I get through? You may notice some kids videotaping us as we scroll about. Don't worry about them, they're world star hip hop fans. They're hoping to fight break out later, they can post some shit. You may also notice as we scroll around the way for some sisters in the room. Halloween is every goddamn day. All kinds of checkup on their face, funny colors running through their hands. Some of the younger brothers like wearing name brand jeans, but for whatever reason, they can't seem to hide their damn underwear. They all seem to run with their hair and their hands to the car. There's Tony.
Come through, Rob. Come through.
Antonio. See, the federal government is where he makes his dollars, and he realizes he gotta act like he got some sense. So when he gets around white folks, he tends to lose his ghetto accent. You know, talking more distinguished, using what they call proper English. Hold on, before y'all know how they do. High five, pal. Way to go, Susan. How are you? And the brothers be like, something wrong with this picture. As soon as he get off He going straight to the liquor store. He gonna get a bottle, a roll up, a pack of Newports, and all his strong black brothers gonna turn right back into all of his niggas. Y'all see the jackass, the brown trash, the telephone pole. That's the death side of one of our dealing party. And if anybody wants to get high real quick, just one block on the land on the drug market. Well, the tour's just about ready to end, friends. But I'd like to throw something out to y'all real quick. Ain't it funny how y'all just walked in the hood and nobody got killed and didn't none of y'all get your asses whipped? I'm sure it comes to some surprise, friends, especially considering the way they portray it from the local news and CNN. This is public housing, basically what folks can afford. Did you know that you didn't need a police escort? Squad cars rolling around the way. See, they only come out with the fire trucks and the ambulance and it's time to spread the yellow tape, unless it's killing nigga day. But anyway, we are human beings, not animals. You just walk through a predominantly black neighborhood, not resident evil. Black, white, rich, poor, hood, red, trail, poor, trash, and the end of the day, people are still people. And all people until they do themselves unworthy deserve respect. So don't mock and stereotype our policies, because yes, we are God-killer people by nature. But that don't mean you can't get your damn chin checked. I hope this was educational for all of you. For me, it's been fun. So till the next time I catch y'all niggas around the way, have a nice one.
Brother, yeah.